Hello, hello, I'm Crystal Green.
Hello, hello, I'm Tracy Smith. It is Wednesday, September 8th, and this is Channel 1 News.
How much television do you watch? Well, a recent study shows the average teen watches around 21 hours of TV each week. For most teens, TV is the main source of information. So wouldn't it be better if you could watch several sources and compare the information, you know, so you could draw your own conclusions about what they were telling you? Well, here's the problem. One company could be supplying most of your information, information you thought you were getting from different sources. And that's the red flag some media experts are raising after yesterday's news from Wall Street. Viacom announced it is buying what is perhaps this country's best-known broadcaster, CBS, for nearly $35 billion in the biggest media merger ever. On the surface, it's hard to see how you are affected. Viacom Incorporated buys the CBS Corporation, creating a media powerhouse. But keep in mind, we're not just talking about two little companies. These are major corporations with vast holdings. In fact, do you recognize any of these logos? MTV, Paramount Television, Paramount Pictures, King World, Nickelodeon, Showtime, VH1, The Movie Channel, Blockbuster Video, Simon & Schuster Publishing, and many more, all now owned by one corporation, Viacom.
We will create an $80 billion giant, the largest media transaction in the history of the media industry, and this will generate enormous benefits for the shareholders of both companies.
Sure, the shareholders will benefit, but what about the rest of us? Not so long ago, there were really only three television groups supplying information: CBS, NBC, and ABC. Then came the influx of technology. Satellites, cable, and computers made it cheaper and easier to get the information to us. So there were more smaller companies providing us information, ultimately giving us more choices. But then those little companies started merging and growing into giant corporations. For instance, in 1996, the Walt Disney Company, already a movie, animation, and theme park giant, bought ABC. ABC already owned ESPN, ABC Radio, several newspapers, and parts of A&E and Lifetime Television. In fact, Channel One News itself is owned by a multimedia company, Prime Media, which also owns magazines such as Automobile, Modern Bride, Soap Opera Digest, and 17. So it's easy to see that while you may have nearly 100 channels to choose from, you may have only a handful of companies supplying that information.
It's very important to understand that a lot of the choices that you have in movies, in television, in music that you listen to, on the websites that you look at, ultimately come back to the same group of people that are making decisions about what goes on and what doesn't. They're trying to please you. Their ultimate responsibility is to make a profit.
Profits like the $21 billion News Corporation recorded last year. Have you ever heard of News Corporation? Well, chances are you are familiar with its holdings. News Corporation owns 20th Century Fox, the Fox Broadcasting Network, magazines, newspapers, and even the Los Angeles Dodgers. So what do teenagers think about this merger?
I think it's all right for the two companies to merge as long as a monopoly is not created. And it's kind of a safe thing because the government has laws against monopolies.
The benefits that we see with having so many media outlets is that they're able to compete with each other and produce the better quality entertainment or the better journalism. Having one of these companies just simply eliminates that competition.
Of course, with that power comes the responsibility to be educated about it. And just as healthy teenagers make educated decisions about what they're going to eat, they also should make educated decisions about what they're going to watch. You should absolutely know that it's maybe a half a dozen corporations that control almost all, make all the decisions about what you read, what you listen to, what you watch, what you see on the internet, the music, the movies, the magazines, the television. It's something that you should know as an educated consumer.
Like we said, the CBS-Viacom merger is just one of many giant media companies. To see some of the others and the companies they own, check out channel1.com.
And next, a look back at some of the stories from the summer of 1999.
What are you doing?
What?
You're eating M&M's. Yeah, so are you.
Well, I'm not an M&M. You don't eat your own kind, it's unnatural.
Here, give me that.
Oh, I like crispy. Give me the bags. Oh, that's just disturbing.
Do you know how to drive? How to say, hey, that's a foul in Japanese? Do you know where in the heavens to find a human voice? Where in your soul to find character? Do you know the shortest distance to a college degree is a straight line called discipline? Do you know how to walk it? Be all you can be.
A lot of big stories happened this summer while you were out of school. We brought you a few of them yesterday, and now it's time to bring you a few more.
Immediately after the earthquake hit, people here knew exactly what to do. Search for family, friends, neighbors, find as many survivors as possible.
John, we're all very,
very sorry.
I guess we're putting all in soda.
Although we were surrounded by terror and destruction, we still stood strong. We have prevailed. We have overcome. Each of us is the spirit of Columbine. Welcome home, rebels! It's time to begin classes. We are back.
The attitude was very positive. We're looking forward to a new year and starting all over again.
Drawn to women's sports, and that's a wonderful thing.
I wish I could be in the finals when I grow up.
More summer stories are coming up later this week, but get ready because your pop quiz is next.
Can you feel the heat? The summer is expected to last through November with the hottest and most anticipated show on the planet, Ricky Martin's Livin' La Vida Loca Tour, brought to you by Pepsi. Pepsi, the joy of cola.
Hey, you guys, I'm Alex Sands, coming at you from Cuba.
Oh, here.
Man, they are armed. The guy back there with a rocket launcher.
Today's pop quiz is about the FCC, the federal agency, which is, among other things, in charge of overseeing the broadcast industry. Earlier you heard about the merger of CBS and Viacom. That merger is possible because the FCC recently relaxed its rules on TV and radio ownership. So here's your question. The abbreviation FCC stands for what? Is it A, Federal Commercial Committee, B, Federal Cable Commission, or C, Federal Communications Commission? Take 10.
Time's up.
FCC stands for C, the Federal Communications Commission. As the name indicates, the agency is in charge of regulating communications. That's radio, TV, wire, satellite, and cable communications. The FCC was established in 1934 and is made up of five commissioners. Their duties include assigning broadcast frequencies and granting TV and radio broadcasting licenses. The FCC administers a public resource, airwaves. That's right, it's the public that actually owns the airwaves. And, of course, the airwaves are what make it possible to have TV, radio, cell phones, beepers, anything that transmits a signal. Nearly every radio and TV station pays nothing for the use of the airwaves. But in return, broadcasters are required to serve their communities. And that's how prominent journalists such as Edward R. Murrow got their start back in the 30s when broadcasters established news departments to fulfill their FCC obligation.
In recent years, the FCC has auctioned off segments of the airwaves called frequencies for things such as cell phones, and that's led some to suggest that commercial TV and radio stations should have to pay for the frequencies they broadcast on as well.
All right, now a quick note. Before the show began today, you probably noticed some new graphics. Every day you'll see these graphics, which represent the types of stories you'll be seeing on Channel 1 News that day and the school subjects that they relate to. The two you saw today were language arts and social studies. There's also health and fitness, science and technology, mathematics, the arts, and school to work, which covers things like going to college and getting a job.
That's it for us. We'll see ya.
I'm ready.